I have finished with the heavens and the earth, and now to finish man. The knee, ah, wondrous creation, a real money-making, but the foot. I'm having some problems with the foot. I need some help.
Hey, Carol!
Hey, how you doing?
Would you get Raymond the Premio, the art change of podiatry in here? Thank
you. Hey, God, how are you?
Raymond,
me a call.
You have brought me my book, the Bible.
No. Your Bible's nice. Going to be the New Old Testament. Hey, man, a beautiful story. This is what's important. This is going to tell us what the foot is made of. Hirsch notes. It's everything in there. What are you doing with this foot? Now look at this. You got all these muscles inserted into bone, God. If I know anything about it, some of these have to insert into other muscles. Some muscles are going to start from other muscles. It's going to be great.
Raymond, what about my saphenous nerve?
The saphenous, that's the other thing. You got the saphenous nerve. It can't innervate anything. It's just going to end.
Raymond.
That's the way it's going.
A nerve that innervates no muscles?
Yeah.
What if the students put... sensory.
No. It'll all make sense. The answer is nothing. Innervates nothing.
Very well.
No, it'll all make sense. It'll be in the notes. Unless
well.
I say something different. Unless I misspeak, then back to the notes.
Very Don't well. We'll compromise what? With it. We'll fill the Kegger's triangle with fat, as you wanted, but we won't tell anyone.
Well, obviously. All right, calm down. Oh my God, my sciatic. Let's get back to work. All right, next thing. We gotta get to work on these tubercles. Tubercle, trochlea, tuberosity. It's all the same thing, but they all have different names. No matter what, this one right here is unnamed. No name to it.
Extensor...
Unnamed tubercle? Because the extensor digitorum brevis, it's gonna start from that unnamed tubercle. Don't give it a name. Okay? Don't worry. It's in the notes. It's actually mistyped in the notes. We gotta figure a way to get all these muscles to stay in the foot. Now this is gonna be a problem. It's a plantar fascia. It's gonna run a whole length of the foot. But I'm telling you, these people are gonna stretch the hell out of it. It's gonna get inflamed. But that's right. That's what they make cortisone for. Am I right or am I right? All right, we'll continue on. We'll put some muscles over here. Now look, do we have any skin? This is freakish. This is scary. You gotta put something to cover all this stuff right here. Now.
Raymond.
All right, God. Now look, I gotta put. This is short. We're just gonna put it here on the side.
I want you to go to Earth. I need you to relinquish your wings.
Oh my God, I like my wings.
And remember, Raymond, carry on. Carry on for podiatry.
Oh God, that's good. That's much better than carry on for chiropody. I'm gonna carry on for podiatry.
Yes,
carry
please
on.
Go.
All right, have a great day. You leave the foot to me.
Go.
All right, open up. Okay.
Now, what to do about dentistry?
Yeah.
today in anatomy with our compartment in the anterior of the leg, the anterior compartment. Now, I hope at this point you all know what a leg is, right?
Are we going to be doing this? Is this going to be an exam?
Yeah, you're going to need to study this. Didn't you get the outline I sent out to the class?
Did you send it to Nadovic?
Right? Okay, now the tibialis posterior runs down the tibia.
Professor, don't you mean tibialis anterior?
Yes, Jane. I said the tibialis anterior. Go with what's in the notes, Jane, all right? Not tibialis posterior. Tibialis anterior comes down. I expect more out of you.
Hey, Mambo. Mambo Italiano. Hey, Mambo. Mambo Italiano. Go.
Hey, how's it going? How you doing? How you feeling today? Hey, ice it. No. You want to put it up? Yeah, like that. So how's it going? What are you doing? Hey, so how's the pain scale? Give me a number.
Whoa.
Is it like a zero? Is it like nothing? Is it something?
Whoa.
1 to 10. I mean, okay. Hey, no. That's not how you do it. You got to put the heat on. I said put a towel on it. Jeez. All right, so tell me a pain scale. I need a number. I mean, you could... Hey, D, how you doing?
Hey,
we all caught up? Are we all caught up?
Yes, no one's come in yet.
All right, tell me if that 2:30 shows up, okay?
Okay,
all right.
I sure will.
Okay, sweetheart.
Okay.
Okay, I got a question for everybody. Is the patient born loose or torn loose? That's the question we need to answer. Show me the article. If you have an article for me, I'll buy lunch. But you know what? You're not going to find it. Hey, D, how you doing?
How you doing today?
All right, I just saw you 5 minutes ago, but how you doing?
I'm doing good.
All right,
I'm
just let me know
today,
if 2:30 shows up, because if not, I don't want to be here.
Okay.
I want to be on a cruise somewhere in the Caribbean. You know what I mean? Either that, I want to be playing some golf.
I know.
All right, we need to review this. I need a volunteer. Tibialis anterior. Jason, settle down. Jason, come on down. Come on, bring that leg of yours with you. Oh my god! Oh, we gotta get a doctor! Okay, hold on!
Jason!
Okay, class, gather around. Perfect example. He broke his ankle. If you knew your anatomy, your ankle wouldn't be broken.
I'll get Labat. He's a doctor. I'll get ice. Do you want ice? Do you want, what can I do? I'll do anything. What can I get for
Steve?
Oh my god.
So all we need to do now is just a little manual manipulation. Let me tell you about manual manipulation. Jason needs me.
Where are you going? This PT shit's a bunch of bullshit. It's just playing around with rubber bands. You know what you're doing?
I'll try.
This is ridiculous.
What's up?
Steve, you came.
Yeah, what's wrong?
Hurt pretty bad, man.
Oh, come on, dude, you're fine. What's wrong? What do you think's wrong with you?
I think you broke my ankle.
What do you mean you think you broke your ankle? Give me a pain scale. What is there, ecchymosis? Come on, you were born loose. We know this. I told you about that.
Tell Chrissy. I love her.
What are you talking about? She's right there.
And tell Carol I'm not going to make it to clinic today.
No. If I got to be there, you got to be there. So we're not going to do a 10-to-1 makeup, all right?
Damn it.
Don't sweat the technique.
Will we be doing this shit one day? If we do this shit one day, I need to make some money to feed the kids.
Doctor. What are you doing? Surgery over here?
The bread.
312 blades are for the private doctor. 15 blades are for surgery. First time in America.
No, second time.
Second time, yeah. In America, we use 312 blades for the debridement. 15 blades for surgery, doctor.
Oh, so this is America.
Yeah, this is America.
Okay.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Tracy, what are you doing over there?
Ooh, is that a nevus?
All right, doctors, we're going to practice steroid injections.
Steroids? I could always use some more juice.
Wait, doctor, what are you doing here, doctor? Hey, we practice on patients here, not ourselves. Let me show you Babo's way, all right? You gotta hold it like a pencil, doctor, like a pencil. You ever played darts before?
Mm-hmm.
You gotta hold it like a fulcrum. Pinky here like a fulcrum, doctor, like a pencil. Okay, let's see you do it here. Babo's way. Wait, no, doctor, like a pencil. Do you listen? No. Obviously not. Okay, you hold it like a pencil, doctor. Pinky, pencil, dart into the skin.
I think I got it this time.
Doctor, stop. No, doctor, stop. Babo's, all right, this isn't working. Not listening to anything we're saying. We need a real patient in here. Jane, get in here. All right, I'm going to show you Babo's way.
One.
You going to take your shoes off, Dutz?
No. Leave them on. I do it all the time.
All right, Siegel, pay attention. Like a pencil.
60.
Might feel a little pinch or a burn.
Ouch!
Hey, mea culpa.
Feel the burn.
No, actually, it was just a little pinch.
Talk about my biceps. 60. 61.
You know what my grandma always says? If the doctor ain't hurting you, he ain't doing his job right.
Charge for diag.
Charge for diag? We're not here fucking charge for diag. I'm trying to get out of here.
Doctor, they just called charts up. Doctor, they just called charts up for it. What are you doing?
They just called them.
You should have known ahead of time. Doctor, what kind of doctor are you?
So, Mike, are you ready to present?
I'm ready. Yeah.
Okay, so we have this patient, and they have this ankle sprain, but I think it's a high ankle sprain, so like, what do you think you should do? Oh, wait, are we allowed to wear scrubs in this module?
Sick and tired of this. You're never going to see your whiteboard again.
I guess we'll just tape them then? All right.
Charts up for diet.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first patient's fine. Out of my way, nerds.
About 600, 700.
Hmm.
Ow!
How
doctor,
opinion?
Really?
How long have you had this?
I have no clue. Now
does that hurt?
Ow, that hurt.
What about this?
Yes.
Giving this?
Yes.
What about when I do this?
Yeah.
What about this?
Ow!
Wait, just one more. This?
Oh, that hurt.
Okay. So there's some things we can do for this, okay? Surgery down there to correct this.
Surgery?
Surgery.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Is that going to be painful?
It probably will have some pain to it. And it probably will feel better when we're done.
Okay.
But it probably will function better too.
Okay.
Now, I'm a surgeon, so function is not my main concern. But when I'm done, this bunion will be the best looking bunion ever. Okay,
right.
I'm going to talk to Dr. Patel, and we'll be right back.
What do you have for me, Andy?
Well, doctor, I am a 27-year-old diabetic female who presents today with a painful right hallux abductophalgus deformity. It is tract-bound, and she's been feeling this pain for about a year. She has taken Advil, and we've tried all conservative therapies to date. I think she is ready for surgery at this time.
That was a fantastic presentation! I know everything about your patient now. We should schedule surgery for tomorrow. Andy, give me a hug, my boy. Very good. I will meet you in the patient room, okay? We'll talk to her. Okay, bye. Andy, what do you got for me?
She's a diabetic patient, and she's 27, I think. I'm Angel. I'm 56, and she has a blood sugars in a 218. 218. She's got track bound, and I think the tenosynovitis.
That was a horrible presentation! That's the worst presentation I've ever seen!
It's
I know nothing about your patient, 218, tenosynovitis. What is this?
If only there was a way, you could go back to the chart and learn more about the patient, even ask the patient a question. But you did not do that. It's a horrible presentation, the worst I've ever seen. Go to the patient and be a real doctor. Oh, Andy!
Take off that stethoscope, you look like a nerd!
I'll show them all. I'm gonna write so many papers, I'm gonna become the best DPM in the world. They'll call me One Shot Meyer.
I get you kids every year with that. Nothing. It means nothing. Oh, someday these kids will learn it. I don't think they listen to me anymore. Hello?
To bring you, I'm gonna put your name on my next article.
Andrew? What the hell is that? Huh. He's gonna put me in a paper.
I hope it doesn't hurt much.
Hey, folks! Not with One Shot Meyer!
Got rhythm, I got music, I got my man. Who could ask for anything more?
Hi there, I'm Mark Harpo. How are you
doing? I'm Mike. How you doing, Doc?
Good. I read in your chart you're here for a diabetic risk assessment.
Yeah, I've been having trouble laying off those sugars. You know, that diet's a pain.
You know, that's the number one thing about being a diabetic, is being able to control the sugar. You gotta stay away from the things like chips, cookies, soda, blueberry pie, frosting, just a nice dollop of ice cream on the side, red velvet cupcakes with cream cheese filling. Glazed donuts are killer. You gotta stay away from them. With the little sprinkles on top, flavor crystals that just melt in your mouth and make you just wanna.
Take my shoes off for you, Doc.
I don't think that's gonna be a problem.
Never seen you looking so lovely as you did tonight. I've never seen you shine so bright. I've never seen so many men ask you if you wanted to dance. They're looking for a little romance. Give out.
My love.
are over. And life is like a song. Oh, yeah, yeah, at last.
Oh, hey, wait a minute. I forgot my white coat.
Hey, Leslie, can you help me out with something? It's nice to meet you. So, what brings you in?
I've been having a lot of heel pain lately.
I think you have a more serious problem than that.
Like what?
You have gingivitis.
Gingivitis?
It's a very serious problem. It's actually an epidemic in Ireland. 90% of the population has it.
Never heard of it.
Well, there are some treatment options. There's something for you called Marigold. Have you ever heard of it?
No.
You should definitely try it. I've had a lot of success with my gingivitis patients with it. Now,
what do you also think about lasering those freckles off?
Laser?
You ever heard of laser?
It's nice to meet you.
Where are you going? But wait, there was a finale.
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Sam Spadone.
Hi, I'm Mary.
I don't shake hands.
Oh.
What are we here today for?
Why do you have a microphone?
Well, if you notice, these walls are parallel at 90 degrees with an acoustic ceiling. And taking these into it?
I think I have an ingrown toe now.
Okay. Let me measure some things. I need to check your reflexes.
What is that?
This is a reflex hammer.
It looks like a hammer.
What is a hammer in your definition?
Yeah, like a hammer with nails.
You mean mycotic nails? Why would I use a hammer on that?
What are mycotic nails?
Oh. Put your leg up. You can't flinch like that. I won't get a proper measurement if you do that. Fine. I have other tools to measure what's wrong with you.
Are you a foot doctor?
The body is connected, if you'll take note. So when I treat the foot, I have to treat the whole body. And what I'm trying to measure with this instrument is the sine wave and the crystalline structure in the soft tissue of your body, which is nearly dehydrated, and I'm losing you, I see that. I'm trying to measure how asinine you really are.
Excuse me?
Asinine. Do you need me to spell that?
Excuse me?
Oh, do I really have to repeat myself?
I don't need this. Find another doctor.
My sometimes girlfriend is asinine. It was more of an objective observation than a emotional issue. Why can't people be more like computers?
Hello, Mr. Smith. My name is Jin Sub Song. I understand you are here for a diabetic foot risk assessment.
That's correct.
How's your blood sugar?
I'm not really sure.
Okay. What is your height and weight?
I am 5'6", and I weigh about 200 pounds.
Okay, 5'6", and 200 pounds.
It says here, you are too fat.
What does that mean?
That means you have to lose some weight.
What are you trying to say?
That you have to lose some weight.
What does that mean?
Did you know that it takes 15 minutes of walking required to burn off one can of soda?
Oh, soda. No.
It takes 15 minutes of walking. That is a lot of exercise.
Yeah, but I don't know how to do it.
You don't know how to exercise?
No.
Let me show you!
Squeeze your glutes and eat those fruits. You have crunchies, no more munchies. Bless those cheeks and no more sweets. Lose some weight, improve your game!
See, very simple. Can you do that for me?
Okay. What we have here, doctors? It's a serious problem. It's a bunion. And this bunion has been a problem for too long. It's time she goes shit herself.
We should give her orthosis. $400, I get a new carpet for my lake house. This is America. This is how I make money.
No more nice podiatrist. It's time she get the knife. Jenny, baby, what you say? What you think?
Well, you gotta think. What is the IM angle? Does she have metadoctus? What about degenerative joint disease? What about her medications? Does she have any allergies? Does she like Pinot Grigio? Is she a diabetic?
Pinot Grigio? What?
I'm sorry, I must have gotten carried away. I just thought she might have good taste. I have no friends.
It's okay. Jenny, baby, you make good points. We need to bring in some big guns.
Hey, speaking of big guns, I ever tell you guys from South Philly? Let me tell you a story about South Philly. Me and this Pollock, this buddy of mine, this big Pollock, we walked down, these two Puerto Ricans come my way, and I'm like, hey,
this story is not good, not very good.
What's that good? You don't like Puerto Ricans?
I don't like Puerto Ricans, but no, the story not very good, no. I heard story, no.
Hey, Bubble, okay, later, man. Okay, it's okay, Bubble.
No problem. Very good.
What I think we need to do is if we want to stay away from prosecutors, we're going to need to do the scarf.
Scarf? Scarf, you kidding? But I'm not trying to keep it warm on its way to a school. This bunion. Bunion is a no joke.
Well, at least you would do well with the prescription for Percocet.
No! Oh, Dios mío. Martin, ya,
She at least has the 3 Bs for surgery. Blood, breathing, and Blue Cross.
I just mean Martin, ja, okay, please, thank you, okay, please.
I already have the steroid injection ready to go.
We're going to need the wise words of a wise man. Kieran, what you say? What are your wise words?
This is Bonnie. She have met the doctors. And I am in.
I already know it. Joe.
Morning, Kieran. How you doing?
What do? There's a patient upstairs in the ASC. Severe IM angle. What procedure do? Help.
Would you have him brain fart? It's an offset B. What? I don't understand. What's the problem today?
Offset B.
And please get rid of that beard. It's creeping me out. I don't ever want to see you in it again.
Thanks, Joe.
Dude needs to lay off that Irish whiskey.
Kieran?
Offset D.
It's perfecto. So you will lose his job, no?
Oh no, not me. I'm booked. We're going to the Notre Dame football game this weekend. Can't you tell how excited I am?
Okay, very good. Back to business. I have kids to feed. They're not even my kids. What if she refused surgery?
Okay. I guess that means it's up to...
Is there the Amlectin that brought the donuts?
No, Carpo. Third for lunch, okay?
Okay, doctor. Let me tell you something, okay? I know just the man for the job, okay? I'm going to call Miguel Troiano. If you know Kieran not be able to do this, Miguel, he will do this. Miguel, tú quieres un paciente para hacer juguía. He picky Spanish, it's okay.
I just don't get how we're supposed to be getting any money for anything. Or even why we even do this anymore.
That's what you get with capitalist America and their corporate greed.
That's all. Zed, what do you think?
Mike, why are you so mad, man? You know how much they pay us for bunions in Syria? 3 goat. In America, they don't even have goat.
You know what, Syed? Under my universal healthcare plan, I'll give 2 goats for any procedure. Hell, I'll even accept food stamps. And if you want a camel to make you feel like you're back home in Syria, we can get you a camel.
My man.
Wake up!
I had this crazy dream, like, you were there, and you were there, and you were there, and that dude was there.
7.
Yeah, I was there. And, like, I just dreamt that and all these clinicians were students, and...
This is crazy. It's just insane.
Yes. I should have went to NYCPM.
I don't care! I love it!
I don't care.
to please. We gotta kill this switch. You're from the 70s, but I'm a